All right, welcome everybody. It is Sunday afternoon. It is noon on Sunday. You know what that means? It is DCWF Full Tilt. I am the DCWF Commissioner Member, the Bull Rossini, and sitting with me and is Mount. I just want to let you know what a pleasure it is for you to be sitting with me on commentary today.
Oh, it's my pleasure, honey.
The DCWF fans, mark your calendars. Next week, April 25th, we will be going over to Bikers Bayou. DCWF Hall. Wow, we got a lot of great matches lined up for you there. We got a lot of great matches lined up for you there. You want to stick around? You want to TP your friends, TP your enemies? Because we got great professional wrestling action. And we're going to kick it off right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this first match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 285 pounds, he is the Gambler, Ace Nightfire. From Dallas, Texas, weighing in at 243 pounds, he is the SLCW Men's Champion, the Cowboy, Drewski Huxley. Drewski Huxley, a fan favorite here at the DCWF, set to take on Ace Nightfire. Former DCWF world champion in his own right, Drewski Huxley, Ace Nightfire at the peak of their careers in second life professional wrestling, and they're going to open it up. Referee Rail James has the call today. Thanks everybody for coming out, and we are underway. There is the opening bell. Drewski Huxley, Ace Nightfire. Both future Hall of Famers here. Drewski Huxley is already a Hall of Famer. And there we go. Ace Nightfire starting out with some good old-fashioned chain wrestling. Drewski Huxley counters the wrist lock. Both of these guys have had long storied careers in the DCWF and in Second Life Wrestling in general, and they show no signs of slowing down. Drewski Huxley will be defending his SLCW championship next week at Bikers Bayou as we present Hog Wild, Ace Nightfire. back in there with that side headlock. Mama, you like sweaty men wrestling?
Yes, I do. I like it a lot.
Okay, and so go.
I just don't want to get none of them big boots in my face.
Well, you're in the wrong business.
No, I'd rather give them than get them.
Collar and elbow tie up now. Rejuski Huxley with that wrist lock. They're trying to wear Ace Nightfighter down. Ace Nightfighter has that that cut the deck, that modified cutter. And he can put on you at any time. But if you wear his arms and his wrist down, it makes it a little bit more difficult. Rejuski Huxley with a little bit of strategy here.
That looks a little painful.
Well, that's the idea. Hurt your opponent, right? That's what we do.
Right.
Oh, and there's that pin by Ace Nightfighter, or Juicy Huxley, schoolboy roll up. Ace Nightfighter kicks out. Juicy Huxley trying to put this one away quickly. And not so easy on a veteran like Ace Nightfighter, though. Ace Nightfighter is no rookie. He's no spring chicken. Called him Ace AC. What?
There he goes working on that arm again.
Oh, Ace Nightfighter using that size in that string, picking you up, atomic drop. I think that hurt Mama.
Just slightly.
Don't break the man's ass bone 1 week before a big event. That's all I'm trying to say.
Right? What?
Because you know there's no cast for that, right? You can't just, like, put a cast on it. Break
ass. Oh, I know. I know. I've broken mine. Had to sit on a donut.
I mean, it'd be really silly walking around biker body with an ass cast on, but... Oh, and an inverted atomic drop, disrespecting the nuts.
Meaning like that, and he's going to be a couple octaves higher.
And somehow Ace thinks he deserved it. Don't know.
The only way she's going to stop that number is if y'all put her in a match.
She's been in a match.
That's not
and
a...
Now Ace Nightfighter with that bear hug and then taking Drew down to the mat. She's been in a match. She's fine.
But she must have this thing for your bald head then.
Who doesn't?
Me? You asked.
Ace Nightfighter staying on the assault here against the SLCW men's champion. And another bear hug. Ace Nightfighter really knows how to work in that bear hug, really knows how to get his arms around the ribs and squeeze you and try and get the life out of you there. He's a big, strong guy, and he proves that each and every time he gets in the ring. Rejuski Huxley, no weakling himself. But referee checking in here to see if Drew wants to give up that bear hug. Looking secure there in the center of the ring. Oh!
Rung his bell, didn't he?
Yep. Juicy actually fighting his way out of it now. And a big chop followed up by a bionic elbow off the rope. Drew fighting himself with that two count only. Referee counts two. Ace Nightfire not able to put the SLCW Men's Champion away right here on the opening match of Full Tilt. Not just yet. Referee Real James claiming Ace got those shoulders up. Ace finally able to get Drew out of the way there. Drew Huxley showing some signs of fatigue here as Ace Nightfire is not playing around. Drewski Huxley firing away with some knees to the gut, dropping that knee down on Ace. Ace Nightfire trying to get out from underneath. That drop kick to the knee, sending him down.
Now he's got to make the side hit.
Lock in. Yeah, he's wrenching it in. Yeah, Mama. Hope he puts some deodorant on.
I hope so, too. At least washed under there.
Ace into the rope now with that Irish whip. Thinking about big pop-up power bomb. Are y'all ready?
That's gotta crack the back.
And a pin attempt. 1, 2. The 2 only. Drew Huxley gets that shoulder up. Fighting champion. This is non-title at this point, but Drewski Huxley certainly doesn't want to go into Hall of Wild with a loss under his belt. And neither does Ace Nightfire, for that matter. Drew still feeling the effects of that, though, favoring his back as Ace Nightfire starts to bring him to his feet. And just, he actually goes underneath that clothesline, up the ropes, and fires through with his own jumping clothesline. Ace Nightfire down. Drew Huxley has found some momentum. If he could capitalize here, Mama, he might just pull out a victory in front of this crowd at DCW at Full Tilt.
Yeah, and might screw on chicken's asses too.
Cowboy!
We're going to the top rope. Ace Nightfire, at best, get down on the mat. Oh, and the flying elbow drop, Macho Man style, yeah, off the top rope. Ace Nightfire caught every bit of that. You're actually now measuring Ace, hitting him up, and there it is, the cattle driver. Will Ace Nightfire get up? Is the pin. 1, 2, 3. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the Cowboy, Drewski Huxley.
I don't think I'd want to meet Drewski when he is ticked off.
professional wrestling action, because we got tons of it. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this next match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Japan Town, San Francisco, California, weighing at 225 pounds, he is Hideo. And his opponent, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 280 pounds, he is Gunter Hyde. Shurio taking on Gunter Hyde in the second match, DCWF Full Tilt. And don't forget to stick around long after this, because we got plenty to go for you. And mark your calendars, for next week, 12 noon at Bikers Bayou. See Mama if you want to LM, because we're going to be doing DCWF all wild. It's going to be a blast. I'm gonna wear leather. It's going to be hot.
Yeah, Hog Wild's going to be fun.
All right, Gunter Hyde, obviously with the size and strength advantage over Shirio. Shirio with the experience and the more agile of the two. Shirio kind of fearless as to who he's facing off against here as they circle each other up, size each other up in the ring. And this one is about to get underway. Go, Carl. Horrible tap. We are off. Test of strength here, and Shirio is holding his own. And arm drag takedown from Gunter Hyde to get this one started. Shirio works his way back up into the cover, elbow tie up. Shirio trying to fight his way up. Throwing that elbow, reverses it. Shirio, a great technical wrestler in his own right, can reverse and get out of many a hold. Front guillotine applied, and Shirio drags his opponent over to the ropes. And Gunter Hyde now using that size and that strength, picking him up, big toss, sending Shirio across the ring. Shirio finding himself in some trouble here in the early stages of this match.
It looks like Rail's got her hands full with these two.
Gunter Hyde staying on the assault with that front face lock, looking to do some damage here, looking to put a hurting on Shirio. Dragging him over to the corner now, Shirio looking for that opening, that opportunity, and Shirio gets whipped into the corner.
He hadn't had the breath knocked out of him, he does now.
And now Gunter laying in those punches. Referee trying to get things out of the corner. Neither man really paid attention. Referee having a hard time keeping control in this one. Gunter Hyde is a bit unstable.
A bit?
You never met my ex.
I take it I don't want to either. Gunter's going after the referee.
And Gunter now back to the corner, laying in those punches from that that second rope. Furio finding himself in a whole ton of trouble right now. Making their feelings known. Irish Whips and Ushurio into the corner. Might be a bad idea. Gunter off the ropes himself in a big boot right to the face of Ushurio. Here's the first pin. This could be all one, two. Two count only. Gunter far more worried about getting in an argument with the referee than he is his opponent, and there it is, that leg sweep. Ushurio making his way, out of, fighting himself out of the hole he dug in. At the beginning of this match. And that elbow strike. Oh, spinning back kick, step up, enziguri. Ushurio using some of that martial arts background right now and some of that agility to dig himself out of trouble in a pointed elbow drop right to the head of Gunter Hyatt.
Can he get his point across?
I don't know. We'll see. Off the ropes with that rebound wheel kick there. Ushurio is starting to gain ahead of steam, starting to gain momentum. Here's the pin. One. Gunter gets out of it. And that cursed rolling elbow. They had no series of kicks right to the ribs. Ushurio wrapping his leg around the rope. Ushurio paying no mind to the damage he took earlier in this match. And he is all out and all in right now. And Gunter Hyatt in a bunch of trouble. To the center of the ring now, and that enziguri sending Gunter right back down. Ushurio's got his momentum going, he's got his head of steam, and I don't know that Gunter is going to be able to dig himself out here. Ushurio looks like he's got some ideas about that corner turnbuckle, and there he goes up top. High rent district, high risk, high reward. He's setting up, and there he goes off the top rope with that knee drop connecting. Got his Gunter across the chest. Here's the pin. One, two. Two count only. Ushurio not backing down. Waiting in that series of kicks. Gets his leg caught, however. And followed through with a big clothesline. Gunter Hyatt cutting Ushurio off post haste here in the second match. Full tilt off the rope. Big leg drop. Ushurio finding himself down on the mat with pounds of Gunter Hyatt coming down on him.
He about put him through the mat with that, didn't he?
Nah, our boards are pretty strong. I bought them at Home Depot. Gunther going to the top rope himself right now. Second rope comes down, that big elbow drop right to the head. Gunther Hyde swinging that momentum again here in this match. Take a little bit of time to talk to the crowd, but giving Sherio that breather. Sherio now at least able to get up to one knee. Gunther Hyde, I don't know that he studied the tapes, really. I can't say. And it gets sent to the rope, but the Irish whip rolls out of it. Sherio with that Helicarana sending Gunther down to the mat. Got to watch out for Sherio. He's wily. He knows how to get in and out of, like, you know, get in and out of trouble, and he's doing it right here.
If he can just keep this head of steam up, he might have a chance.
Up on the rope now, measuring Gunther Hyde up. Sherio taking his time. As Sherio goes down with that high knee, Gunther Hyde rolls out of the way and out of the ring.
And where is Gunther going?
I have no idea. Referee on the count, Gunther Hyde refused to get back in the ring. And well, the referee has called it. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner by count out, Sherio.
Gunther thinks he won.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is a triple threat match. Introducing first, from Belfast, Northern Ireland, weighing in at 125 pounds, she is Emma Gray. and her opponents. From Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. Weighing in at 135 pounds, she is the dancing darling, Yuri. And from Sao Paulo, Brazil, weighing at 159 pounds, she is a capoeira striker, Vanessa de Silva. And the SLCW Women's Champion, Kira Scarborough, making her way to ringside. She obviously has an interest in this match. She's going to find out who she'll be facing next week for the SLCW Women's Championship at Hog Wild.
Hi, Miss Kira.
All right, triple threat match. First one to get a pin wins. That's the way it goes. Pin or, you know, what have you. There's no disqualification in this match, and there's no countouts. All three of these women more laid claim to the opportunity to go and face Kira for the SLCW Women's Championship at Hog Wild. And the head of talent relations, Joey Scarborough, decided, hey, here's how we're going to do it. Set up a little tournament. This is the final round of that tournament right here. Bell triple threat. ECWF Women's Division has been on fire as of late, no doubt in my mind. We'll be seeing ECWF Women's Champion Gina Rose in action later on tonight. But right now, this might be the most consequential match of the evening, as the winner gets a ticket, the golden ticket, all the way to Hog Wild next week. Eric taking a minute to wave to her friends. The bell's already rung. I don't recommend a lot of waving after the bell rings, but she's free to do what she wants with this.
Maybe it's part of her strategy to throw the other two off.
Sure. And the other two are going at it right now. Eric, you're definitely a nice person, but oh, he following it with that going back in time clothesline. Yeah, if you knew anything about her, she's all about the ages. Oh. Handstand leg drop on Emma Gray. Eerie, former DCWF Women's Champion, former SLCW Women's Champion, looking to climb that volcano once more, if you will. Vanessa de Silva finally getting up. Vanessa de Silva. Interesting. Oh, big long kick, big spinning kick up, and oh wow, I can't do that. I cannot. And a big leg drop from Erie, the dancing darling. She's fought wars in this ring, certainly when she laid her claim to be the right to be the number one contender for the SLCW Women's Championship. She's certainly the veteran of the three in the ring. And when she staked that claim, I don't think anybody would have an objection. And now that I want my MTV, that modified wrenching wrist lock. Erie's got some strength that you wouldn't expect from somebody her size. She knows how to move those microwave ovens, custom kitchen deliveries. She knows how to move those refrigerators. She can lift them color TVs. And she's got that lapel lock on Vanessa Da Silva. Referee checking in, but Emma breaking it up. That's one of the dangers of a triple threat match, is there's always somebody lurking. There's always somebody waiting in the wings. You gotta put two people out, basically, if you want to win.
Right.
Vanessa Da Silva, she got a reprieve. Emma kind of saved her from that, tapping out from that lapel lock. Make a back. I would never make a back to the future ref. Great Scott. And up with that big drop kick. And a great jawbreaker sitting very down to the mat. It's really taking charge of this match. Vanessa Da Silva finally up on her feet, but up against the ropes. Gray opting to stay on Erie right now. Oh, yeah, Vanessa Da Silva sending Erie out and way the hell over the top into the crowd. Where she's going, she don't need roads. And that drop toehold from Vanessa Da Silva now, sending Emma Gray right down to the mat. Emma Gray losing some of that steam. Vanessa Da Silva looking to get her first real opportunity, a DCWF goal, cartwheel leg drop. And she's athletic, and she's just got all kinds of stamina, and she can really hold her own in the ring against these vets. It's a very colorful. Her outfit is, colorful. And there was a time that Erie was thrown out of the ring, hurt her back when she came to. She had an idea for the flux capacitor. It's what makes time travel possible. That is heavy. And there's a pin, two count only. That big DDT from Emma Gray, not enough. Not enough. Vanessa Da Silva gets that shoulder up. You gotta get back in there, Eric, because if you don't get back in there and finish the dance, then I'm never gonna be born. Hard corner splash, Vanessa Da Silva finding herself in trouble. Emma Gray stepping up and taking control of things right now. Hey, my guitar is feeling pretty good. And neck breaker from Emma Gray, Erie getting back in the ring. Emma Gray not able to put Vanessa away while Erie was on the outside. Now she has to contend with Erie as well. And the figure four head scissors locked in. Referee checking in on Vanessa DeSilva to see if she's going to tap out those figure four head scissors. No, oh, and Erie with that big leg drop breaking up the party. It's Matt. I honestly, I'm sitting here and I'm trying to find my words because I got no predictions here as to who's going to go to face Kira next week at Hog Wild. It could really be any one of these three. If you take any options to wax off the rest of the silver. Yeah, I'm laying through with those headbutts. Vanessa DeSilva on the receiving end of some pretty heavy headbutts. And Emma Gray trying to get up to her feet.
Ooh.
Ooh. Inzaguri right to the physique. Erie's face don't work. She can't fight. Oh, big bicycle kick from Vanessa DeSilva. Both of her opponents down. Rare opportunity in a match like this for her to capitalize and wrap it up. Impressive. Just because she's Irish, she has Guinness in her blood? Oh, and that take a chill pill. When Vanessa into the mat, Erie looks like she might have this one sewn up. She might have this one wrapped up. And the pin
gets broke up.
McGurry breaks up that pin before the referee can even get down. Now she can pick from her opponent, and she goes for Erie. Sending Erie into the rope to Emma Gray. As you can see, is getting wind of Vanessa DeSilva back. Oh, ho, ho, ho! The best cyclone kick. And a Yakuza kick, Erie on the outside of the ring. Emma Gray down. Vanessa DeSilva, all she's got to do is pull this off. This is hers to win at this point. She's got Erie on the outside of the ring. Emma hemmed up on the inside. Oh, and those kicks right to the face. Vanessa DeSilva going for broke here. She sees the opportunity to compete for DCWF gold next week at Hog Wild, and she is going all in. Then there's the pin, one, two, and no, Emma gets that shoulder up.
And how did she do that?
It would be this.
LOL, smiley face, LOL, smiley face.
And now Vanessa DeSilva to the top ropes. This could pay off for a high impact maneuver, and Emma Gray's condition may put her away, and Vanessa DeSilva could be going on to face Kira Starbucks next week. There goes Vanessa DeSilva with the Meteora. This is all but over. She's just got to get over to make the pin. Erie nowhere to be found on the outside of the ring. And yes, Mama will be in that match next week as well. I got to make a decision, and I should have put Mama in a match.
Yeah.
I love it when I get to have the button.
That's okay. Mama's been practicing with the alligators.
And Vanessa da Silva on the charge gets caught in a super kick. Emma Gray making her way back up to her feet, however. Erie proving to be a bit of a distraction. Vanessa makes her way up to her feet, however. Erie proving to be a bit of a distraction on the outside of the ring. She's up on that top rope. And Ireland's fall. Vanessa da Silva gets caught, goes down. And here's the pin. 1, 2, 3. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Emma Gray.
Okay. It's going to be Emma and Kira and me.
It'll be Mama T, Emma Gray, and Kira Scarver for the SLCW Women's Championship next week at Bikers Bayou at Hog Wild. One of the bigger matches is going to be in that show. If you don't want to miss it, mark your calendars. Put an alarm on your phone, whatever it is you got to do. 12 noon at Bikers Bayou next week, because you do not want it. Introducing first, from Central Europe, aside from City, weighing in at 155 pounds, she is the Dark Siren, Samantha Oxy. And from Baldwin, Florida, weighing at 118 pounds, she is Jaxi. Let's get elevated. Melanu. From Hollywood, California, weighing in at 120 pounds, she is the DCWF Women's Champion, Queen Gina Rose.
You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah, so I'll be sending our attorney Ted Buckland over to make sure that all your affairs are in order.
I know, referee Rail getting these ladies ready, and the bell goes.
Now, Jaxi Bellano, former DCWF Women's Champion, as well as the last current DCWF Women's Champion, Samantha Foxy, been all over the place in Second Life Wrestling recently, throwing her hat into the metaphorical ring, if you will, here at DCWF, and has not disappointed yet.
Oh, absolutely not. Sam Foxy's been shown really good since she just came here at DCWF. But Gina in control of this match from the start.
You saw the fans' reaction to Gina walking out. You know what? I don't think she cares.
Okay.
And she's picking Jaxi Villanova up by the hair. This is why I don't have hair, in case you guys are wondering.
Sure, that's the reason.
Followed up by the break a bitch. Samantha Foxy down. Jaxi Villanova down. Back Gina handling business here in the center of the ring. Picking Jaxi Villanova up. Ever since Gina has won the DCWF Women's Championship, she's really been unstoppable. And now she is slamming Jaxi's head into that corner turnbuckle. Hey. stomping Jaxie down there. Gina Rose trying to stay in charge of things. She's got Jaxie on the sidelines for a while, and now it looks like she's going after Samantha Fox.
Yeah, no, I mean, say what you want about Gina, but ever since she won that belt, she really has been on fire. She's had complaints along the way.
No.
She doesn't think she should wrestle, but, you know, when she does, she's always a tough cookie to beat.
I like cookies.
I like cookies, too. Yeah, where's our cookies?
Well, you call them biscuits, don't you?
We call them both, depending on what it is.
Yeah, and here's the first pin. One, two, and no, Jaxie Villeneuve gets that shoulder up. Jaxie Villeneuve also, let's not forget, holds the Women's Chaos contract right now. She can compete anytime, anywhere. So she could definitely throw a monkey wrench into the machinery for whatever's coming up next week at DCWF Hog Wild.
Yeah, I've honestly thought she'd cast that in, but Jaxie just been there. Just holding on to that contract.
I've honestly never met a picture cat before in my entire life. But...
Actually, there with that rolling knee coming back off the ropes.
And another one, Gina Rose here, finding herself in a little bit of trouble. Jaxie Villeneuve going up to the top rope, find out how many lives she has. Front flip, leg drop, connects. Gina Rose just kind of pounded into that mat there. And here's the pin, one, two. Wow, we could have seen an upset victory here.
Yeah, Gina in trouble for the first time really now in this match. Jaxie's still over on the floor there. Sam Foxy's still over, struggling on the floor there.
That's a big hit right at the beginning of the match, and it took a lot out of her. She struggled to recover. Took that low blow. And Jaxie Villeneuve, as nice of a person as she is, she's got to be able to capitalize on this right now.
Yeah, it's like a few of it. I think sometimes that's a downfall. You know, she can be too nice at times.
Well, she's helping. So she helped Samantha Foxy up, letting Samantha Foxy get a little bit of a receipt here on Gina Rose. Gina Rose now up against the rope. Jaxie Villeneuve, I can't decide if she's an evil villain or not because she's getting to take a break right now. She's getting to catch her breath.
Yeah, maybe she's a bit shrewd than I thought. Oh, here goes Foxy lifting Gina right up. Yeah. Oh! And over the top rope to the outside.
And DCWF Women's Champion tossed out of the ring like a rag doll. Even Jaxie and Samantha. Jaxie able to catch her breath a little bit here. Samantha trying to recover still from that low blow. I mean, I just sympathize. I've been in that region before.
No doubt Jane will have something to say that she's badly done to her because she got thrown to the outside of the ring.
Could be.
Here comes Jaxie off the ropes. Basement drop kick. Coming off the ropes again. And there we go. A very nice enziguri.
Jaxie Villeneuve, very quick, very agile, very skilled. And Jaxie.
Oh no, absolutely. And these two have been through quite a bit in their time.
You would think they would just kind of hug it out.
I know, right? Hug it out.
Hug.
Foxy getting up to her feet now. Oh, big shoulder block taking Gina down. Obviously, Samantha and Jaxie taking this opportunity to team up on Gina, but at some point, something's got to give if you want to walk away the winner in this match.
Yeah, absolutely. Sam, knowing that and going straight after turning that big burst of energy, just a pure adrenaline throwing Jaxie all over the ring. And leading in with those kicks.
In a dark tornado. But as Samantha's signature moves, followed up by the pin, two count only, Jack to get your shoulder up. Samantha Foxy, make no mistake about it, she's very dangerous in the ring. Don't let the fact that she's spent a lot of this match on the sidelines fool you. She's very cunning, she's very dangerous, she's very strong, and she knows how to hurt you, and she's demonstrating that right now, going back and forth between Jaxie and Gina.
Oh, absolutely. One wrestler definitely in danger. Never count out this Samantha Foxy.
That Cyclone Ride to get another signature move followed up by a pin. But Gina managed to kick out just in time. Samantha Foxy, though, in command of the situation right now.
Kiss the boat.
Sending Samantha Foxy head over ass there. And she goes for that pin. One, two. Samantha Foxy gets the shoulder up. Jaxie Villanova, nowhere to be found to stop that one. That one could have been over right then and there as the referee considers it a 2.9.
Samantha Foxy barely getting the shoulder right at last minute.
And now the double bisou. Jaxie Villanova. And here's that pin. Kisses her on the nose. One, two. No, somehow. Somehow.
Yeah, count. Oh!
Yeah, now we're starting to see that kind of, that bit of an alliance there between Samantha and Jaxie break up a bit. Which is always going to happen in a match like this. But I think the crowd kind of really got excited to get the piss taken out of her. Here's that Irish whip. Oh, an exalted lariat.
One, two, and a three.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Samantha Foxy. and gentlemen, this next match is a 15-minute time limit match. It is set for one fall, and it is your main event. Introducing first, from Swansea, Wales, weighing in at 198 pounds, he is the Celtic Dragon, Mitchell Weiser. And from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 236 pounds, he is the DCWF Heavyweight Champion of the World, the man, Michael Thomas. Here we go, main event set to get underway. Michael Thomas facing off against Mitchell Weiser, non-title action. However, Mitchell Weiser does hold the Chaos for the contract in the men's division. He won it back at WrestleFest. He could do what he wants, when he wants, and he could take his opportunity once a year to regain his DCWF World Heavyweight Championship. Jerry, as you know, last week you've been given the right to pick Michael's opponent at Hog Wild. Do you have any ideas? Do you have any clues? The man's tongue didn't come through cutting.
I've got a few ideas. Not going to show my hand just yet. I'm going to make sure it's the perfect opponent for Michael at Hog Wild.
Kurt Hennig?
Damn, how did you know?
Ah. Yeah, Michael with Mitchell in the corner right now. This match 15-minute time limit. Referee keeping tabs on the time. keep things out of the corner. As you know, Michael beat Mitchell, you know, showing up to the mat in the BCWF World Heavyweight Championship. Mitchell has been looking to climb back ever since, and he's got an opportunity here, you know, especially since he's holding that contract, to get that piece of business done.
Absolutely. I mean, he's got like, he can do what he wants anytime he wants. So, you know, Michael needs to realize he's got more than one target on his back now.
And if he's going to win, it could happen. We've seen contracts cashed in on a regular show before. Yeah, but the Wojcik's really been waiting to get a crack at him ever since his loss. So, you know, Michael Thomas, for as well as he's doing right now, my advice to him would be tread lightly. Mitchell Wojcik does happen to be, in my opinion, the most dangerous man in the business today.
Yeah, I think I'd have to agree with that. And this is just, we know what Michael's like. He has a tendency to come and run his mouth. And yeah, he does back it up when he does that, but as I said, he's got to tread very carefully now.
And that the Wojcik finding himself in a hole. Well, there you go. Michael would try another kick, and Mitchell Wojcik catches him. Mitchell Wojcik, martial arts background, wrestling background, BJJ background. Really, he's one of the most well-rounded individuals that have ever graced the presence of the sport of Second Life professional wrestling. He's got a million ways to hurt you, and he's trying them all here on Michael today. I think maybe in the back of Mitchell's mind, he's thinking, dude, I can wear him down, and it doesn't matter if we hit the time limit. I got this contract. I can get it back. I can walk out of here today. You know, or maybe, just maybe, he's been sitting in Jelly's office, and they've been cooking up a little plan for next week. I don't know.
Better security on my office.
Look, my money next week is on CM Punk.
CM Punk?
Oh, yeah.
How much you going to put on that?
I know Samoa Joe's got to wait 90 days, so.
And I'll now hold it for a bit. We have one, two, just the two count.
If you don't have anybody yet, I mean, I'm still in pretty good shape.
You've just beat me to it. I was going to say, how do you not know I'm going to come out and say numbers of Bull Rosini?
But you have to tell me because I got to get my panties out. I got to dust off the nylon.
Oh, don't worry. I'll let you know by Friday.
Okay.
Now, that I'd like to see. I ain't seen numbers wrestle yet.
Or maybe I just want to get really into Michael's head. You know, what have I brought out? Dundee. Pat's Jiggler.
Pat's
you know, really, really throw him off. Now, I'm sure Michael's prepared for a lot of opponents for next week. But I bet he hasn't thought about Patch.
I kind of wonder, I have to talk to the championship committee, under the terms and conditions of your retirement, could you pick yourself?
Unfortunately, no.
Yeah.
So, as it stands, I am retired. I cannot, under no circumstances.
Michael, now up to the...
I no longer have a wrestling contract. Michael in for the pin, two count only.
You know, I heard Papa Shango was looking for work.
Oh, now that would be one. That'd definitely be a good choice. never know, maybe it might get stuck in the ring, all you hear is, damn!
Oh, that would be great. Or what if the glass breaks? Like, and Mitchell with a big spine buster. Like, let me set the stage for it. Oh, no, Mitchell, wait a sec. Michael Thomas looking to protect his future children. And the referee says, touch his balls and you're disqualified. Because it's not that kind of wrestling. There are places for that in Second Life.
Well, now I've got him in that sharpshooter. You know, Michael likes to come out here and trash a lot of the DCWF legends that have come before him. What if we saw, like, a Big Evil?
Big Evil coming out. Wow. Take it back. Or Ari Lane.
Yeah, Ari Lane.
Or Voodoo.
Oh, yes. So that would be a good one.
Okay, so let me tell you, like, my ideal situation, right? You come out to the ring, you announce Michael, and Michael comes out and says, all right, it doesn't matter. I can beat anybody. Who's going to be my opponent? I can take anybody that the DCWF could bring in you if you small. Or self high five. Another boy shut Michael out of the ring. Now we gotta call this match, man.
So we might get a little bit of it's DDP.
DDP.
Flying lariat from the top
to the outside of the ring. Oh yeah. Woo!
Yeah, I don't think the DCWF budget stretches that far.
Oh, shit. It'll take $5. He's broke.
Slap shit out your ass, bitch.
Ooh! And that big snake eyes off the rope, Mitchell Wojcik punishing Michael Thomas right now. I don't know, what if we could set it up so that next week Michael gets eliminated?
Well, from the whole show.
And referee up to 7 at the waistband, jumping back in, breaking the count. Ring veteran knows exactly how to keep the suspense going. 5 minutes remaining in this 15-minute time limit match. Mitchell Wojcik working Michael down here. In the next 5 minutes, he might earn himself a spot in infamy. And since Michael on down the line on the outside of the ring, into the almost to the steps on the other side.
Now laying in those punches to Michael. Here he goes.
Let's get ready to jiggle.
Yeah, I think I'm leaning on the whole Patch Jiggler.
You lean it toward Patch?
I mean, think about it. How awesome would it be? Patch Jiggler, the World Heavyweight Champion.
Wow. I don't know if Mama would appreciate that too much. And the pin after the Lion Salt. Two count only. Mitchell gets his shoulder up. And a Blue Thunder backbreaker from Michael Thomas. Mitchell Wojcik running. Michael Thomas running out of time, and Mitchell Wojcik running out of room. There's the pin. 1, 2. This is it. No. He gets the shoulder up.
Michael definitely see by his fierce fall he had that there.
2 minutes to go in this match. Mitchell Wojcik trying to find if he's got anything left in the tank. Big suplex. Mitchell Wojcik in a whole lot of trouble here. Michael Thomas, if he can set something up here, if he can put something together, he's got a puncher's chance. Mitchell Wojcik trying to get to his feet now. Both men getting up. Michael Thomas getting up. Very slowly, this match is taking a lot out of both of them. They've thrown everything but the kitchen sink at each other. Michael Thomas over to the ropes. Mitchell Wojcik. Oh, that sling blade. Mitchell Wojcik has a short window of time here to get it together. And the psycho driver. Mitchell Wojcik can get over and get that pin. He's got a fighting chance. 1 minute to go. 1 minute ago, Michael is down. The psycho driver has put him out. Mitchell on the top rope. Sizing him up, measuring him up. It looks like Michael broke his hips.
Mitchell going off the top.
Michael getting out of the way. Michael getting out of the way of that splash. Time is running out. The clock is ticking down. During this 15-minute time limit match.
Oh, eliminated. Now I get it. Sorry, that took me a few minutes.
Yeah, both men going for a clothesline and connecting. Referee going to count it down, but I don't think it's going to matter. I think the clock's going to wind down. And that's going to be it. Two of the best in the business today have flattened each other, and there it is. There is a 15-minute time limit with the Wojcik first to recover and get to his feet, or at least start to get to his feet. But the Wojcik up now, goes over to the corner. Michael Thomas out of the ring. This one has gone a time limit draw. And a crowd, I think, would like a few more minutes. Mitchell has that briefcase. Mitchell has that briefcase, and he's holding it up. He's signaling to the crowd that he might want to cash in here, right now. It looks like he's going to do it. It looks like he's cashing it in. Handed it off to the referee. All he's got to do is hand it over. And Michael Thomas with that chair. Stopping Mitchell before he can cash in. And with Mitchell Wojcik, thought he saw the opening. He thought he saw the moment. Each of that briefcase got ready to hand for the referee. Michael Thomas stopped him short in his tracks. And I don't think Mitchell Wojcik's going to cash in today. And Michael Thomas makes his exit from the ring. Referee checking in on Mitchell. Well, Mitchell doesn't get to cash in today, but he still holds that briefcase. And who knows what's going to happen. When Mitchell Wojcik is going to strike, Michael Thomas, I think, realized today that that target on his back just got a whole lot bigger. All right, folks, we want to thank you for coming out to DCWF Full Tilt. Make sure you check us out next week at Bikers Bayou for DCWF Hog Wild. There's so many questions to be answered. Lots of matches have been made. So many questions to be answered yet. Who knows what's going to happen when we invade Bikers Bayou? There's going to be tons of people there. There's going to be motorcycles. There's going to be beer. There's going to be cages with dancers in them. I don't even know. It's just going to be a wild time. Cannot wait to get there. Jelly, Mama, thank you for sitting with me today. It's been your pleasure.
Yes, it's been my pleasure.
All right, we will see you all at DCWF Hog Wild, or as we like to say, Hizzle Wizzle, next week.